morning, all of you. This is S. Mali Babu, working as associate professor in the St. Martin's Engineering College. Today, I am going to be discussing one of the concepts that is nothing but the strings in the programming language, C programming language. So, how to declare the strings? What is the syntax for that? How we supposed to be assign the values with the help of the assignment operator? How to read the strings with the help of the built-in functions which are already defined in the stdio.h header file? All these things we supposed to be discuss. I will try to explain with the help of the example program. Now the point is that our intention is how to declare the string, how to read, how to display the elements on the console, moreover how to find out the length of the string with the help of the built-in function, as well as the without using the built-in function, how to find out the length of the strings. All these things I will try to explain with the help of the example program. So try to understand that. If you want to declare the string, for example, in the case of the string, what will happen? How the compiler will be allocate the memory? All these things we will see now. First, at the time of the writing the program, the basic intention is find out the length of the string. Header file hash include stdio.h. So this is the standard header file which is usually the almost all programming languages. After that main function, void main function. Then I supposed to be declare the array, character array. How to declare the character array? With the help of the cap character array str. For example, I am taking the two strings str1, one more string str2. Why I am taking the two strings is that string 1 value will be assigned at the time of the declaration. String 2 value I suppose to be read from the keyboard. Find out the length, all these things we will see now. Here, string 1 value I suppose to be assigned with the help of the assignment operator at the time of declaration itself. So that is done with the help of the assignment operator. I suppose to be put in the double quotes. Welcome. Here the point is that string 1 is the one of the character array which can be stores the string which is assigned in the double quotes. That is the first string. I am taking the one more string, that is nothing but the string 2. String 2 of 15. This value I suppose to be read from the keyboard for your better understanding. One string assigned with the help of the assignment operator. Second string we supposed to be read from the keyboard. Next one is I would like to find out the length of this string. So I is the first string length, second string is I am taking one variable I, which is used to find out the length of the string. Moreover, second string I supposed to read from the keyboard. How to read? For example, printf, enter second string. So this is for our convenience purpose. We supposed to be display the message on the console. How to read from the string with the help of the keyboard? That is the getS function I am using, which is also defined in the stdio.h header file string 2. Whatever the string is supposed to be entered, that will be read into the string 2. That is also the character array. Simply assign the first string as well as read the second string. Now what I am doing is that string 1 length I supposed to be calculated with the help of the string length built-in function. Second string length we supposed to be calculated with the help of the without using built-in with the help of the for loop. We will see now. So string length, we are having the one of the function strlen function, strlen of string 1. String length is the built-in function which is already defined in the string.h header file. String 1, it is taking the one parameter. String 1 value will be calculated, how many characters are there. Those characters will be assigned to the integer variable. So here I am taking the one of the variable integer I. Here the point is that it can be returns the numeric value, integer value. That value command store in the I variable. Here we supposed to include the one more header file, that is nothing but the hash include string.h header file. We are using the built-in function now. So strlen function is available in the string.h header file. Now I would like to find out the string to len with the help of the for loop. How to find out, we will see now. For loop, I am taking the one of the variable j, j is equal to 0, str2 of j not equal to backslash 0, j plus plus, terminated by the semicolon. This is a for loop which is easy to find out the second string. How this will be calculated? For example, j is equal to 0. Assume that string 2 is the having the character. For example, when you declare the 5 characters str2, the compiler allocates the memory like this. Str2, the compiler allocates the memory. First one generally represent with the help of the str of 0. Name is str2, no? str2 of 0. Second one is str2 of 1 and so on. Last one is 15, no? str of 2 of 14. So the compiler allocates the memory like this. Whenever we are declaring the string 2 of the 15, 0, start from the 0 to up to the 14, 15 characters will be stored in the string 2 value. For example, simply assume that this is the hello string, hello, hello. Anyway, by default, all the strings will be terminated with the help of the special symbol, that is nothing but the backslash 0. Here, how to find out the length of the string 2 with the help of the for loop, we will see now. J value 0, j is equal to 0 is str of 2 of 0. Str of 2 of 0 means the character which can be stored in the str of 2 of 0 position, that is nothing but the h. H is not equal to backslash 0. It is a true. It can be increment the j value. Initially j is equal to 0, for example, j increment, j value become the 1 now. Initially j value 0, j value is the 0. Now it is increment 1. Again it can be checked the character str of 2 of 1. Str of 2 of 1 means e character. So that means the character which can be stored in the str2 of the 1 position, that is nothing but the e value. E not equal to backslash 0, is again find true. Again j value increment, j value become 2 now. Again str of 2 means e value. This one, these are the index value. This is the 0 value, this is the 1, this is the 2, this is 3, this is the 4, last one is the 5. Those are the indexes of the string 2. 2 means 2 is the L. L is also not equal to 0. Again, J value increment, that is the true. J value increment 3. Same process will be repeated until J value 4. 4 means str of 2 of the 4 is the hello. O not equal to 0. Again, 5. Again, J value increment 5. Now, the point is that str of 2 of the 5th location, str of the 2 of the 5th location is the backslash 0. Here that is a backslash 0 not equal to backslash 0, that is a wrong. Wrong means the controller come out of the for loop. So finally j value contains a 5. So 0 to, so 5 caps is there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 caps is there. The length is available in the j variable. So this is the way we supposed to be find out the length of the string without using the built-in function. First string length we supposed to be calculated with the help of the strlen. This is the built-in function which is already available in the string.h header file. So now find out the, now we already calculated the length of the first string as well as the length of the second string. Now what we are doing is that these two strings will be done. So now the point is that I would like to display the same program. I would like to display the string in the reverse order, for example. How to do that? How to do that means, for example, I would like to find out the length of, display the string in the second string, str2 in the reverse order. How to do that? For example, yeah, otherwise we do only str1 is there, str1 is already assigned with the help of the welcome. I would like to print the string 1 in the reverse order. How to do that? I already find out the length of the string length, which is already available in the I variable. So I would like to print the reverse order, means what I am doing is that, for example, assume that this is the string. I will take the one more example. Yes, fine. Just observe here. Just observe here, this is the string 1. String 1 is the memory will be allocated like this. String 1, first character of 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on, so many welcome. More 2 characters. E last one is the extra 0. So this is the str 1 of 0. This is nothing but the str 1 of 1 and so on. Last one is the str something. Yes, fine. 1 of 19 up to 19. Now our intention is we would like to print the str 1 in the reverse order. How to do that? For example, first character as well as the last character I am taking. How to get the last character? Last character is nothing but the length of the string. That is already available in the I variable, that is the integer variable. I contains the integer variable, I am having one more variable. That is also we supposed to declare I as well as the J. Two variables I am using within the program. I value contains the length of the string. What I am doing is that, here the logic is that first character I value 0, I is 0, str of the 1 of the 0 value, that is nothing. That is nothing but the W. Last character str of 1 of the 7, no? Length of the characters is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 characters are there. 7. Last character, first character, J value, I value contains the last character, str J. Yes, now these two are interchanged now. If it is the fine, if it is the equal, the we supposed to be swap the two values, first location as well as the last location values are interchanged. Simply interchange, again same process will be repeated. I value again increment, take the one more variable length k value. If it is the equal, those simply two values are swapped. How to do that we will see now. Simply for our better understanding, this value will be stored in the k variable. For example, length of the string, how to do that? For example, same process will be repeated while k less than or equal to j. Here simply what we are doing is that we will take the one more variable here, character variable. So that is nothing but the dump variable for the swapping purpose. K less than or equal to 0, k contains the length of the string. Instead of this k, better m. I value, length of the string, first string length. Take the one more variable k less than or equal to I. This is fine. Initially, take the one more integer variable. So that is nothing but the k. K is assigned to the 0. K is assigned to the 0 value. What we are doing is that I supposed to be interchange the two values. How to do that? Yes. K value. K is nothing but the str of k. Str of 1 here is an example, str of 1 value I supposed to be assigned to the temp variable. After that what I mean, I value, I is nothing but the str of 1 value, that is nothing but I, which can be stored in the str of 1 of k value. Finally, temp value I supposed to be assigned to the str of 1 of I variable. So this is the swapping of the two values. After that, I value may be incremented. J I means what I am using it instead of I, we are using the K variable now. So K value increment, I value simply decrement. So this is the logic of the same process will be repeated until K and I both reaches the middle of the position. So this is the way we supposed to be reverse of the given string. At the end of that, what we are doing is that we supposed to be print the final string. Can I write here print of reverse of the given string. Reverse of the given string is equal to, for example, percentage, that is the batch percentage, so that is a format specifier. Reverse of the string available in the str1 variable. closing of the main function. So this is the one of the simple program in order to reverse, how to reverse of the value. Just I am giving the briefing. Within the program, what we are doing is that read the one of the string one value we supposed to be declared as well as initialized with the help of the assignment operator. String two value read from the keyboard with the help of the getS function. Find out the string length value, first string length, with the help of the built-in function string length. After that, find out the length of the second string value with the help of the for loop. This is done. After that, this logic is nothing but the how to reverse of the given string, first character as well as the last character. How to get the last character? Last character means length of the string. Length is already available in the I variable. Last character, first character. First is taking one more variable k initially is equal to 0. Last value is the e value. Both are what we are doing is that we supposed to be interchange the k value as well as the I value with the help of the swapping technique. Swapping is nothing but the interchanging the two characters. Same process will be repeated until k and I simply reaches the same position. As long as less than, we supposed to be continue the same process again. Finally, k value decrement as well as the I value decrement. Finally, string 1 contains the reverse of the string. The result will be displayed here. So, thank you one and all.